We've seen already in this class how you can go into the History tab to take a look at the notifications in general, and that would be selecting notifications by, you know, the notification itself. So as I select one versus another, I'm seeing the notifications just for, you know, that particular selected notification. But what if you wanted to look at it a different way? You want to see it by the recipient. And namely, you want to see it as the recipient you're currently logged into. Well, that's the option that you see down here called MyPI. With MyPI, you'll be able to see all of the notifications using the same user interface, you know, showing active, recent, time range, etc. And what you're going to be seeing is just those notifications that you are subscribed to. And when I say you, I'm talking about the Active Directory user you're currently logged into. So if you're not using Active Directory at your site, this MyPI feature is simply not going to work for you. But again, as I said, we do use Windows Integrated Security so that we do know how you're logged in. And if you recall, when we set up these notifications, you know, one of the things that we can set up when we do that is we can set up subscriptions to contacts who are Active Directory users. So if you recall, when we did a search here, I can search through all of the Active Directory users. Now, right now, you've probably noticed that my MyPI is empty. Now, I'm currently logged in as the Windows administrator, and I have no subscriptions as the Windows administrator. If we take a look at the subscriptions tab, you can see administrator is not subscribed to any of these. Well, I can change that real easily. Let me just go ahead and drag this over here. I'll add a subscription to that notification. I think I'll add a subscription to this notification as well. There we go. I'll go ahead and check that in. And now we can take a look at MyPI, and you can see these are, you know, we're listing here what we're subscribed to, and now we're able to see the active, the history, etc. for this set or for this particular user. And we've got all the same user interface options we saw before. We can condense this to just look at the individual alerts, where we can see each individual little event within the notification, just like we could in the other one. Now, this the observant student here may notice, hold on a second, wasn't I getting all kinds of notifications in Outlook? If you recall, all during this class, you've been seeing little things pop up over here saying, here's a new notification. But how was I getting that if I said I haven't been subscribed to any notifications? Well, this is just a minor point, but what I've been doing for testing purposes is I've been running Outlook as a different user. I've been logging in by choosing this to do a right click, a mouse click on the Outlook icon here, or you can also do it by holding, you can't just do a right click from here, you have to hold down Shift, do a right click. You can choose Run As, and then you could log on as any user you want for Outlook. It's a nice little trick for testing notifications if you have access to different accounts that you can test with. So that's why I've been seeing all those notifications. I've been logging on as different users to see these notifications appear in Outlook. But anyway, a minor point, just wanted to clear that up in case anybody's wondering, hey, why were we seeing all those notifications if you haven't been subscribed to anything?